Good morning, members of the press, and thank you for attending this morning's TTFA virtual press briefing hosted by the Trinidad and Tobago Football Association with me, head coach of our men's national senior team, Angus Eve. We've called this press briefing to allow you, the media, an opportunity to interact with Angus as he has selected, he has announced his 20-man squad that will depart, not reach shores in Trinidad and Tobago, but will join the rest of the contingent in Doha en route to Thailand. Over the weekend for the King's Cup 2022 that will be played in Thailand. For the sake of those of you who have not yet received the squad, even though I would have sent it out a short while ago, I'm going to call out the list of 20 players, and then we're going to go straight into questions for Angus. But the first player on the list on my list here is Ajani Fortune, followed by Alvin Jones, Andre Fortune, that's a brother of Ajani Fortune, Anthony Herbert, who is one of the newcomers coming into the squad. He's a forward at Madison FC in the United States right now. Some of you all would have recalled him from being a former member of the National Under 17 men's team and also a former St. Benedict's College player. Aubrey David, Daniel Phillips, Jesse Williams, John Paul Rushford, Judah Garcia, Kareem Moses, Kevin Molino, Keston Julian, Leston Paul, Levi Garcia, Marvin Phillip, Neville Hackshaw, Nicholas Frenderup, Noah Powder, Ryan Moore, and Sheldon Batu. So there you have the 20-man squad that has been selected by our head coach Angus Eve for the upcoming King's Cup in Thailand. We're going to go straight into questions for Angus, but for the sake of those of you who have not recorded the members of the squad, I will send this to you following today's press briefing as well. Angus, over to you, but by a show of hands, can we see who wants the first question for Angus this morning? Gaston, you there?
Yeah. Morning. Morning, coach. Morning, Sean. Morning. Everyone.
You have an opening question for Angus.
Yeah, you hearing me?
Yeah, hearing you too.
Yeah, first question. Coach, how does it feel to have the services of Kevin Molino back? And what is the mindset in heading to Thailand? What do we want to achieve?
Well, firstly, it's always great to have Kevin in the side. He adds an added dimension to the team. He adds that creativity, that the level of maturity and the level of commitment. We all know what Kevin has gone through for the past couple of years by way of injuries. And he's always bounced back, and he's always willing, from the time that he's ready to play, you know, want to be a part of whatever Trinidad and Tobago is doing at the time. So credit to the young man for that. And basically, you know, we wanted to play, excuse me, a different type of opposition. We've been mainly playing teams in our confederation. And we wanted to test ourselves out of our confederation and have the opportunity to see the players in a different type of environment. And basically, you know, to give them that level of experience and exposure.
All right, next question, we go over to TTT News. Go ahead.
Hello, good morning, Angus. Sean, I have two questions, and if I can ask them back to back.
Different
topic, but the first one is basically on the selection of the squad. You know, I noticed the squad is a very experienced one with some newcomers, obviously. But I don't envy your task with regards to picking a squad at this point in time with no football and trying to make it for the past couple of years and all our neighbors and opponents, you know, they in action. So I just needed to touch on that again, you know, to reemphasize how difficult this task is to pick a squad with no local football going on.
It's extremely difficult, Ham, and thanks for the question, because I've been very vocal on it from the standpoint of, you know, I played most of my career locally and would have been still a member of the national team. So I want to afford the local guys the same benefits. We tried to have a two-week camp similar as we did when we went to the Gold Cup. It had no football at that time. And we brought, me and my staff brought the players up to a good level of match fitness that we were able to compete in that tournament. So I wanted to do the same thing here. Unfortunately, The financial situation in the FA did not permit me to have that type of environment laid up for the guys. And so basically, you know, to no fault of ours, the staff, we had to pick primarily players from outside. And what we did, it was realized Marvin is the only local one is actually traveling. We had, from the time that we knew that we were getting the game, we had Marvin in training with myself and Coach Clayton working on all his goalkeeping stuff and trying to get him sharp. We brought in boys to do shooting and different stuff against him. So he's been training with myself and Coach Ince for the last 3 weeks.
All right, thanks a lot for that one. The other question is surrounding Cyrus. As he's a recall for the Neil Cyrus there after a long while. We haven't seen him in on the national team for a little while. Walk us through that reselection.
Sorry, Cyrus?
Yeah. Sean, did you call Cyrus?
No. I don't think. Daniel Phillips.
Oh, Philip. Oh, okay. All right. Okay. Sorry. We have no more questions.
All right. Next question for Angus. I think Jumani Cox, is it? Your hand is up. Go ahead.
Yes. Good morning, gentlemen. I'm representing Tobago Channel 5.
Welcome.
I just want to know an idea as to how many Tobago footballers are selected.
Oh my word. I don't know how to answer that question because we are Trinidad and Tobago, one country. So I could tell you how much is there 20 Trinidad and Tobago footballers on the team. How much are coming from Tobago naturally? We have about Powder, one who will be a naturalized Tobago. Yeah.
Okay. Just really wanted to know because of our attention to within the Tobago space and how we disseminate the information. But of course, I agree that is one country.
All right. Thank you. Next question. Further questions for Angus? Joel, go ahead.
Hi, morning all. Hoping all is well. Coach Angus, I don't know if you hear me?
Yeah,
yes, I am. Hi, hope. Yes, hoping all is well. I know the Ascension League finished a few weeks ago and they haven't had competitive local football since then. I know you made mention of the fact that the team is predominantly foreign based. But are there any plans for the local based players who were in your ranks? To have them training separately so that for future tournaments they couldn't call ups, or you're hoping that a league starts back so they could get more game time. Thanks so much.
Yeah, firstly, you might have to check your records. The Ascension League finished about a month and a half ago, not 2 weeks ago. And the other thing is, I said in the opening that we did have a camp plan for two weeks so that we could have worked with those guys. So that has always been the way me and the staff work. Unfortunate for us, finances didn't permit at this point in time, and the guys are not in season. But yeah, we hope that a league will start soon so that come March, when is our next official window, that we would have the opportunity, because we had selected a squad of 22 local players to train for this particular tour, but unfortunately we could not get the camp because of the restraints of finances.
Okay, next question, Cunningham, go ahead.
Yeah, Angus, back to you on a touchy subject. You know, I mentioned twice the financial constraints at this point in time in Trinidad and Tobago football, and we understand it's also some administrative constraints with the normalization committee in and stuff. I want to ask you personally, how your staff making out, you know, with regards to getting a team out there for international competition with more or less to say the logistics of that at that trip and so forth. How are they making out with regards to that? Any major hiccups and so forth with regards to travel and stuff? Because at the end of the tour, is obviously about something, you know? And I think, well, look, if you're seeing any bad windows right about now, you know, we can know from now to know, well, look, what's going on in Trinidad football with this team going on this important trip to Thailand, because Thailand is next door.
Well, that's another good question, Ham. And I tend to be upfront. I think people know that. So I would just give a brief layout. The Thailand FA is paying for the entire trip. They are paying everything. They give us a budget for travel. They give us a budget for match fees. They give us a budget for accommodations and everything. And we had to use that budget. We actually wanted to carry 24 players because there was a couple of other. I wanted to carry an extra goalkeeper because we're traveling that far. And we had another youngster. Well, not youngster. We have a player that was playing in Sweden. I wanted to bring him and see him firsthand, Lee Him. Unfortunately, we didn't have that opportunity. We also, as I said, we wanted, there were guys who did really well in the recent concluded local football tournament that it had. We wanted some of them guys in the squad also, but we couldn't train with them. So the financial side of it is hampering the work that we want to do. But as you know, I think there's about a couple of court cases going on at present with the FA, which is hampering the way that the FA could conduct its business right now. And if you look, it's just not football is affected, but you saw teachers, workers from WASA, different government institutions, who the financial pinch is hurting right now in our country. And that's just the way it is. But I can tell you, for the 29 of us who will be making the trip, everything is sorted and organized. The trip is a very long one. We have 4 hours to Miami. I'm just rounding it off. We have 15 hours. We have a 6-hour layover in Miami. We then go to Doha, which is about 15 hours flying. We have another 6-hour layover there. And then we take a plane for another 6 hours over to Thailand. And then from Bangkok in Thailand to Taipei, where we're going, it's another hour and a half flying. So it's a really, we leave in here on the 17th, and we do get there on the until the 19th. For most of the guys, and about six of the guys, they won't get there until the 20th of the morning, and the first game is the 22nd. So it's a very difficult journey for us. But, you know, we felt that it was an opportunity. Otherwise, we probably wouldn't have any other opportunity in the window.
Hey, thanks a lot, Angus. You know, thanks for the details.
Do we have any other questions for Angus at this point? Okay, seems that we're all good. Angus, it seems that they're satisfied with your sentiments expressed this morning. Members of the press, we want to thank you for being here with us. Angus, thank you very much. I will see you very soon. I will be sending out a copy of this press briefing shortly, as well as a document outlining the squad. Thanks a lot, guys. Have a good morning.
Blessings, Aya.